Hello, hello, and welcome. This is a travel video on the DoubleTree Resorts at SeaWorld. I hope you enjoy. Follow me on Instagram at jrose. Here I am driving down this long road. It took me about 4 hours to get there. This is the hotel lobby. Wasn't really much to see. There was a bar, and this is their vacation shop. I guess they're selling dresses and sunglasses if you forgot yours, which was kind of cool. It's a nice little, probably like one of those airport stores. It was really nice. Again, like I said, this is the lobby. There really wasn't much to see. This is the outside. See how lit up it is of the hotel I was at. This is the patio and terrace. This was the supermarket and the pizza area. Oh, hey guys, hi. This was the pizzeria and supermarket here, and some more chairs for you to relax and chit chat some more. Follow me here on Instagram at jrose. This is the hotel I was staying at. This is the only hotel rooms that they had. We actually had to drive around the back way. Ratchet Bingo. They had Ratchet Bingo at the DoubleTree Resorts. That was actually somebody's special event. Like I said, we are at SeaWorld. SeaWorld Fireworks Show. I did not go to SeaWorld, so that's why you see that I am across the street, because I did not go to SeaWorld. I went to a resort. Alberto's Pizza, it was really good. You're gonna have to go inside. Like I said, it was a supermarket. They were open really, really late. So if you forgot any of your chips, soda, snacks, it is a little expensive, but they definitely have it there in the supermarket. Water, juice, frozen meals, coffee. And it was actually mixed in with Starbucks. It was actually a Starbucks and pizzeria, coffee, supermarket. Like, it was all in one, honey, all in one. I don't know if you can really see those prices there. It says garlic nuts are like $6.95. The pizza I had was like $13 total, I think, with a drink. More seating area. And that's the pizza I ordered. It was delicious. For a small little pan pizza like that, I gave it an 8.5 out of 10. And that's because it was super cheesy. It was hot. It was great. Again, this is the picture of the DoubleTree resort hotel that I was staying at. Finally got a picture of the SeaWorld across the street during the daytime. And here we have the directions, the map, the lobby, villas. They had villas, so I was staying in a hotel. They have villas and rooms. The hideaway, I'm not really sure what the hideaway was. Hideaway. Yeah, I don't know what that was. I guess it was just like a little party place. This is the boring game area. They did not have a game area. Excuse me. They had those little checker things. This is their pool table outside. No sticks, no balls. This is the golf area. It was very boring, guys. Like, the game area? No, no game area. So I gave it a 3 out of 10. I think it deserved that. Yeah. So there was only 3 things to play. 3 things. Open field. They could have expanded the game area or something like that in open field. I don't know. Maybe it's for soccer. Some more directions. The lobby. The villas. The tower guest rooms. That's where I was at. Tower guest.
Here, guys. This was a nice hotel. I gave it a 6 out of 10. Just because it was family friendly. There was a lot of open space, but not too much to do. So if you're... I would recommend this hotel if you're definitely going to be outside. So this is a sneak peek of the next hotel that I will be visiting next. I hope y'all like it. Stay tuned for part 2.